Hi, my name is Jacob from Control Byte Company. All you need to know about automation and robotics. Today, our topic is variables types for Siemens PLCs. Let's begin.
Welcome to the next lesson of our Siemens PLC programming course. In this lesson, I will give you a brief introduction to variable types. Let's begin. Under this video, you can download template project for this lesson and template scene for factory I/O. Please open those two environments, open those projects and follow my instructions. Let's move on. In previous lesson, we have declared some variables. You can find them in standard variable table. Those variables are X conveyor 1, X push button 1, and X push button 2. These variables are related to some factory I/O elements. Those elements in our automation system can be described by two values. For example, we have a conveyor that can be turned off and can be turned on. If the variable value is false, it is switched off. If the value is true, it is switched on. We have also input signal from push buttons. These elements also can be described by two values, 0 and 1. The button can be pressed and released, 1 and 0, true and false. Now ask yourself a basic question. If all the elements in our automation system can be described by two values, true or false? Certainly not. Let's switch off the run mode, click on the conveyor, right mouse button, go to configuration and press analog. Okay, now go to view and click dock all tags. Now if you press play, you will see a special tag different from the others. If you control this tag, you can set conveyor speed. You can set conveyor speed from +10 to -10. This is the range of this variable. All the other variables were Boolean variables. It means that they could have only true or false value. This tag is real variable. It means that it can be described by floating point number. Okay, now you know why you need different types of variables for. A little bit of theory about variables and constants. Variable and constant store data. They both have names. They have a specific type. They have address in the CPU memory. Variable changes value while program execution, whereas constants do not change value during program execution. In this table, you can see basic types of variables available in TIA portal. In our Siemens PLC programming course, you will find exercises with practical application with all these types of variables. So far in TIA portal, we have declared bool variables. Let's get back to TIA and declare the other types of variables. In TIA portal, you can declare variables in tag tables, data blocks, or you can declare function or function block. and declare variables in the interface of this function block. Now let's go back to tag table and let's declare variable necessary to control our conveyor by analog value. First of all, we have to map this tag in our driver configuration. As you can see, we have here roller conveyor. This is analog value, but we cannot connect it to any existing output. You have to go to configuration and change count of double word output to 1. Now go back, drag and drop this tag to QD30. Okay, perfect. Now we have to declare proper variable in TIA portal and map this variable to the same address. Let's go to the TIA portal to tag table and let's start declaration by data type. You have to write real, press enter, and your real tag will be declared automatically in the input memory. As you can see, automatically operand identifier is I. You have to change the identifier to Q. It means that this will be output variable. Then you have to change the address by typing the number of 30. Okay. Now we have to change the variable name. Let's go back for a moment to our variable type table and let's check how real variables are described. In our course, we use Hungarian notation. It means that every variable in our tag table and data blocks will have prefix according to this table. Floating point numbers of type real will have prefix of R. In this row, you can see that real variable has 4 bytes of length in device memory. I will show you in a moment how does it look like in memory of the PLC. Okay, now we can change the name of our real variable. We start with R, then capital letter, conveyor speed. You can also add the number at the end of the name. Okay, perfect. Let's check our program. Now we can start PLC sim, download the configuration and our little program to the simulator and check if all the variables are connected properly in the driver. Okay, my PLC sim is up and running. I can activate monitoring in tag table. Let's see if the driver works properly, if the communication is okay. Okay. Release forcing. Now you can start the simulation in factory I/O. And now let's change the value of this variable in the PLC. In tag table, you cannot change the value of the variable. You have a special tool to do this. Go to the project tree, watch and force table, add a new watch table, Here you can write the first letter of your variable and just select it from the list. Okay, now turn on monitoring. Now let's modify the value of this variable. For example, we can type the value of 1, press enter, and you see a little checkbox in this area. It means that if you press this little lightning button, it will modify the value of this variable. So I press this button, and now actual value of our conveyor speed is 1. As you can see on the simulation, the conveyor is moving slowly. If we change the value, 1.5, and press this button, it will go a little faster. You can check the value of the variable in the factory I/O tag list as well. Okay, this is the end of this lesson, of this exercise. Let's move on to the next lesson. I will work on the same project, so please don't close it. You can use it in the next lesson.
If you are interested in PLC programming, just enroll in our full PLC training. You will find the link down below this video.